There was the sound of laughter, and in a moment, it was no more. And so, she took a ring from her finger and placed it in his hands. There was a wit in a man, neither young nor old, but a wit full of an old man's wisdom and a child's wisdom. And then, in a moment, it was no more. And so she took a ring from her finger and placed it in his hands. There was a man, marked with the scars of his love of country, a body active with the surge of a life, far from spent. And, in a moment, it was no more. And so, she took a ring from her finger and placed it in his hand. There was a father with a little boy and a little girl, and the joy of each in the other, and in a moment, it was no more. And so, she took a ring from her finger and placed it in his hand. There was a husband who asked much and gave much, and out of the giving and the asking, wove with a woman what could not be broken in life, and in a moment, it was no more. So, she took a ring from her finger and placed it in his hand, kissed him, and closed the lid of the coffin.
Few events in our national life that so unites Americans, so touch the hearts of all of us as the passing of the President of the United States. There is nothing that adds shock to our sadness more than the assassination of our leader, chosen as he is to embody the ideals of our people, the faith we have in our institutions, and our belief in the fatherhood of God and the brotherhood of man. Such misfortunes have befallen the nation on other occasions, but never more shockingly. We are saddened. We are stunned. We are perplexed. Our nation is bereaved. The whole world is poorer because of his loss. But we can all be better Americans because John Fitzgerald Kennedy has passed our way. Because he has been our chosen leader at a time in history when his character, his vision, and his quiet courage have enabled him to chart a course for us, a safe course for us, through the shoals of treacherous seas that encompass the world. And now that he is relieved of the almost superhuman burden we impose on him, may he rest in peace.
Thank you.
are bound to feel shattered and helpless in the face of our loss. This is but natural. But as the first bitter pangs of our incredulous grief begins to pass, we must thank God that we were privileged, however briefly, to have had this great man for our president. For he has now taken his place among the great figures of world history.
Thank you. Oh. Lee!
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Let us pray. O God, through whose mercy the souls of the faithful find rest, be pleased to bless this grave. Send thy holy angel to keep it and loose from the body we bury herein that of our beloved Jack Kennedy, 35th President of the United States, that his soul may rejoice in thee with all the saints, through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost, amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord. May his soul and the souls of all the faithful departed to the mercy of God rest in peace. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.